Hello everyone, welcome to Varma's Knowledge Shop. Today I am making a video on external features and digestive system of cockroach. It is helpful not only for IPE, it is also helpful for the students who are preparing for NEET. Near my house, I found three girls studying intermediate. They asked me to dissect a cockroach and expose its digestive system. They brought a cockroach to be dissected. With little equipment available to me at my home, I thought to proceed with them. First, let us go to the classification of cockroach and its scientific name. Its scientific name is Periplaneta americana. Let us see its classification. Cockroach belongs to the phylum Arthropoda, class Insecta, order Arthroptera, family Blottidae, and Periplaneta americana. Cockroaches are most successful organisms on the earth. Thus exists everywhere, especially in kitchens, hotels, bathrooms, warehouses, and everywhere. They are successful because of the strong coating on the body, which is chitinous cuticle. It constitutes the exoskeleton. Now our aim is to see the same parts in our sample. We are going to dissect this cockroach and finally expose the structure which is seen in this picture. First, let us see the morphology of this cockroach. If we observe carefully, the total body is divided into three parts. Number one is head, thorax, and abdomen. Head is triangle shaped and it is perpendicular to the body, which is called hypognathous head. So let us see, these are the antennae and they detect the nature of the food they touch. We can see two pairs of wings here, the forewings and hind wings. Forewings are called tegmina. They do not help in flight, but they cover and protect the hind wings. Let us see the forewings and hind wings of the cockroach. So let us see which cockroach we have selected. The cockroach we have selected is male. How do we say that it is male? Because of the presence of two things. Number one is female abdomen is wide, but in this specimen we can see that narrow abdomen is present. And one and very important thing which will separate a male cockroach from a female cockroach is that presence of anal styles. If you observe carefully, you can find that these are the anal styles. Thorax is again divided into three parts. First one is called prothorax and the covering is called pronotum, and mesothorax and the last section is called metathorax. So these are the anal cerci which helps the cockroach in identifying its surroundings. They are thermoreceptors. They can detect our body temperature and move accordingly. They can listen to any animal or any other organism is approaching near it just by listening to the sound waves that come and reach anal cerci. I carefully cut the legs out of the cockroach. As shown in the picture that is seen in the textbook, the leg is again divided into five regions. The uppermost region is called coxa. This is coxa. And the triangle shaped structure is called trochanter. And the next structure is called femur. Femur is the strongest part of the cockroach leg. And next, if you see carefully, you can find that this is tibia. Tibia is the longest part in a cockroach leg. And the last one is called tarsus. Tarsus again divided into five regions. Altogether, the leg can be divided into 9 sections. In broader sense, they are divided into 5 segments. I removed the legs out of this for a smooth dissection of the cockroach. I cut either sides of the lateral pleura so that the connection between the dorsal plate and ventral plate may be removed, and I gently cut it. I took precaution not to rupture the sample. I dissected it. I tried to remove the
ventral plates
carefully so that I can see the internal organs. When I opened it, a white liquid came out. White liquid is nothing but the blood of the cockroach. The blood in cockroach is white in color. It does not contain any pigments such as hemoglobin. So we can see that number of leukocytes or white blood cells are seen in this. They give the color of white, because in cockroach the blood do not play role in transportation of oxygen and carbon dioxide. Oxygen and carbon dioxide directly reach every cell present in its body by the special system which is called tracheolar system. When I dissected and removed the
ventral plates,
I could see some of the digestive system parts. When I gently removed all the parts carefully and with little skill I gained in my intermediate and degree days, I gently removed all the parts which are attached to the body and finally exposed it to the digestive system. If you observe it carefully, it is same as the picture we see in the textbook. So the first part is called esophagus, and the next part, the large and bulged part, is called crop. And after crop, we can see that the special black colored structure which is called gizzard. Gizzard is the structure where food is ground mostly, and it is turned into small particles. As we proceed further, we can see that these are the hepatic cecae. These are the structures which release some of the digestive enzymes that are mixed with the food and help in digestion of the food. After hepatic cecae, we can see that the structure is called mesenteron. After mesenteron, we can see again hair-like projections coming out of the digestive tract. Those are nothing but Malpighian tubules. Malpighian tubules have major function in excretory system. They collect nitrogenous waste products from the blood which is surrounded around the gut. They collect the waste products and finally they send them directly into the digestive tract. After Malpighian tubules is called ileum, and the final part is called colon. Colon finally ends with a structure called rectum, opens directly as anus, so through which the waste products are expelled out. If you observe these two pictures, the dissected and exposed digestive system with the textbook which is seen in intermediate zoology textbook, both of them look similar. So this I exposed to the students and they felt very happy, and finally they thanked me for dissecting the cockroach and showing them the digestive system, which was totally obscure when they were reading. I hope this information helped the students who are preparing for NEET, and also it is helpful for the students who are preparing for intermediate public examinations. When we do something, we remember it for a long time. That is what I too believed in. Students felt very happy and they left home happily. This is all for today. I will come up with another topic in my another video. Till then, take care. Thank you. Bye-bye.